Okay, let's look at one of the hot spots of the Cold War. And if you can tell from our picture here, we're going to be looking at the Korean War. Now, the Korean War took place from 1950 until 1953. So it didn't last too very long, but long enough to cause some loss of life. Now, this is surprising because we've been talking about how the Cold War is a competition and governments fighting, that sort of thing. But there are times when when conflict did take place and combat did take place. Alrighty, during the Korean War, we're going to see who is involved. Well, if you can tell from our map here, Korea is divided into two places. We got North and South Korea. So who's going to be involved? North Korea and South Korea. However, these two guys weren't just fighting each other. They did have support. North Korea is going to be supported by the Soviet Union, as well as China. These two communist countries are going to come in and help support North Korea. Now, as we have learned, the Cold War is all about communism versus democracy. That's right. Okay, so in South Korea, the United States, the anti-communist superpower, is going to be there to help, but they also get the UN to come in and offer some help as well, which would make this communist versus democracy. Now, who won the Korean War? This is going to be a little bit different from other wars that we've studied about because no one won. Instead, an armistice is going to be signed. And an armistice is a cease fire. And cease means stop. So pretty much they're going to stop shooting at each other, stop fighting with one another. This armistice is going to be signed, but no peace treaty has ever been signed between these two countries. So their border here is still heavily guarded, guard towers and that sort of thing put into place. What was the outcome of this war? Well, as we know, no peace treaty was ever signed, but also 2.5 million people are going to be killed because of this conflict, because of this hot spot of the Cold War. Another outcome, when the war started off, North and South Korea were divided at this line right here, but that line has a name. It's going to be the 38th parallel. And a parallel is a line of latitude. So at the third, so it's divided there at the 38th parallel, that line of latitude. And during the fighting, this line moves down, this line moves up. However, when it ends, it's in the exact same spot. So we're going to put as one of our outcomes, it stayed at the 38th parallel. So all of that fighting just to keep the line in the same spot. But let's think about this. If we recall the Truman Doctrine, we wanted to contain communism, keep it in one place. From what I can tell, we achieved this. We did not let communism spread. We kept it in one spot. Alrighty. And then another outcome, the final outcome that I want you guys to look at, it deals with North Korea. To this day, North Korea is still totalitarian, and it is a hot, and it's, well, let's call it a trouble spot. They have been known to produce nuclear weapons. They've been known to associate with terrorist groups. And they are still a problem for us today. We have to keep our eye on North Korea. Now, during this time, Truman was in office. This is the same Truman from the Truman Doctrine. Wanted to contain communism, keep it from spreading. Now, when North Korea came in and invaded South Korea, like we see here, let's clean our map up a little bit. Alrighty, when North Korea came in and invaded South Korea, the U.S. was definitely upset about it. Communism is trying to spread. So we went in, Truman went in, and he talked to the, and he talked, I'm sorry, I misspelled that. He convinced the UN to send troops. Now, as we know, the UN has both communist and anti-communist groups, members who are part of their group. So why would they get the UN to come in and stop this? Well, part of the UN's job is to keep peace. So when North Korea invaded South Korea, they were not keeping peace. And it was the UN's job to step in and stop this from taking place. All right, so Truman convinced the UN to send troops. Another reaction by the U.S. is we made up the majority of those troops. We sent a good number of troops to help fight with the UN. And then one other thing I want you to look at about the U.S.'s reaction. This is not much long. This takes place not much after World War II. And if you recall, in World War II, the U.S. helped to win this war by dropping the atomic bomb on Japan. And some of the people here in the United States thought it would be a good idea to drop the atomic bomb on Korea, on North Korea, to get them to stop fighting, to convince them to not spread communism into South Korea. However, Truman thought this was a very bad idea, because if we dropped that bomb, he thought that maybe this would start up World War III. So, another U.S. reaction avoided dropping an atomic bomb.